Thank you. All right, moving on to Sentra. Of course, you know, Sentra is also a very important sedan in our sedan lineup. And we're making significant changes to this vehicle for the 2010 model year also. Again, enhanced styling, value, and actually some reduced MSRPs on the Sentra here as well. The 2.0, the 2.0S, the 2.0 SL, and the 2.0 SR models on the Sentra. The 2.0 models come with 140 horsepower 2-liter engine. The SER comes with a larger 2.5 liter engine rated at 177 horsepower. And of course the SER Spec B, comes in at 200 horsepower. From a demographic point of view, of course, the Sentra competes head-to-head with the Corolla and the Civic in the marketplace. The SER and Spec V, they compete more with the Civic Si and the Mazda 3-speed. You can see the demographics there. We are right in the heart of this market with those demographics. Sort of curiously, the SER Spec V attracts the buyer with a higher household income, but not nearly as well educated. So that's not a slot I want to show my kids. So getting into some of the product details, the focus this year is on the 2.0 SL model in the Sentra lineup. They've adjusted a lot of content on the Sentra 2.0 SL to emphasize the value of the vehicle and also the price. They've actually taken $1,100 of MSRP off of this model. Did that by taking the leather and putting it into a package, but also we've added content to this model. About $700 in new standard content, including VDC, the standard on this model, body side warnings, and the 4.3 colored audio display that I showed you on the Ultima. The 2.0 SL is also the only trim that receives our new high-value navigation system, which I'll talk about in a few minutes in detail. Also, the rear view monitor, Rockford Fosgate, premium audio system, and the mirror. So the Sentra receives numerous enhancements for 2010, including a new grille, front fascia, revised headlights and taillights, a standard VDC, like I mentioned, on the 2.0 SL model, new fabrics on the interior, and available leather, and the new navigation system. The navigation system is a new high-content, low-cost navigation system that we developed with Bosch. I believe we have a demonstration in the hospitality room. This navigation system is a fully integrated navigation system that is designed to compete with the Garmin units, the aftermarket units. MSRP is $400, which is very, very competitive with those aftermarket units, but it is a fully integrated system, much more accurate, and easy to read and easy to operate than the thing stuck on your windshield with the suction cup. That system is available on the Sentra this year.
Is it an all model?
I'm sorry?
Is it red in all models?
No, it's available on the 2.0SL only, I believe.
Yes.
Yeah. SER also.
And SER.
Yes. The SER and Spec V enhancements, new wheel color, standard VDC and TCS on this model as well, revised instrument panel, again the available navigation system, standard USB and iPod interface, and new cloth as well. So So the big part of the story on Sentra, in addition to the enhancements of the styling and the content, is pricing. The starting out price for the 2.06 speed is the same at $15,420, but you can see that we've actually lowered the MSRP on virtually every model of the rest of the lineup, as much as $1,100 on the 2.0 SL, and on the SCR models, $1,080 MSRP reduction.
Do those prices include destination?
No.
What is that?
This station is $720.
Darryl, so glad you're here. Any questions on Sentra before I move on to Versa?
Yeah, the prices are on the books.
Yeah, we'll get you a presentation.
Yeah, one of the reasons I'm moving kind of fast is I think most of what I'm covering is probably in the books. So. The Versa. Versa is also a very important product in our lineup. It is our lowest priced sedan. But in terms of its competitiveness, you know, it's an extremely well-equipped vehicle, has the most horsepower and torque in the class. Of course, the 1.6 is one of the lowest priced vehicles in the U.S. at a starting price of under $10,000. Great fuel economy, and this vehicle in 2010 will also have the new in-dash navigation system and very high IHS rating as well. From a demographic point of view, of course, this vehicle competes with the Aveo, the Fit, the Accent, and the Yaris. Median age there, 52, that's a little bit deceiving. This is actually sort of a bimodal distribution of our buyers. We have a very young buyer, and then we have an older set of buyers as well. And so you average those out and get about 52, but that number doesn't really tell the whole story. 51,000 HHI, and college grads are about 46%. So here you can see a photograph of the exterior enhancements for the Versa. New 16-inch alloy wheels, a new front grille, and new 15-inch wheel covers. The SL model gets a standard sport exterior that was a package previously, and now it is a standard model. From an interior point of view, we've updated the seat fabric and the door trim. The new audio lineup, new available wood grain on the SL model, and the sport interior is optional on the SL hatchback and the medium design. You can see that. There's a shot of the sport package on the 128 SL model. So the Versa lineup, from a price point of view, in the 1.6 base, under $10,000. The price increases on this vehicle were very, very modest. The 1.8 sedan price is same as 2009 levels. The 1.8 hatchback goes up $40 from 2009. And the 1.8 SL model was an increase of just $200. And that's despite all the content and enhancements that we've done for this vehicle.
And these do not include destination?
They do not include destination.
Why is the CVT confined to the 1.8 SL?
So we have a 4AT on the lower price models and the CVT on the higher price models. I'm not sure if I have a good product answer for that one.
Yeah, for the 1.6, the reasoning behind it is because the engine, we already have the combination built for other products in other markets. And in terms of cost, it was just easier to package the 1.6 with a step transmission. For the 1.8, I would have to check. I'm not honestly sure whether it's a step transmission for the S as opposed to the SF.
Thank you. More expensive transmission than the 4AT. Probably needed to exist in a higher level vehicle.
How much more expensive is it in this sense? Or compared to a 5-speed automatic?
It's probably comparable to a 5-speed automatic, I guess. So there's our complete sedan lineup for 2010. Again, lots of enhancements in terms of visual appeal, styling, value to the customer, with the features that we've added, as well as the pricing adjustments in some of the models, and our technology we have. So, can I answer any more questions for you? Or defer the questions to Daryl. I apologize for that. I'm responsible for Altima and Maxima, so some of the details of the first
Yes, four questions. The new navigation system,
yes.
The inexpensive one, that's available in which cars?
That's available on the Sentra and some models of the Versa.
And the ones in the Altima and Maxima, the higher end?
Yes. The Altima and Maxima get our 08IT system, which is a higher end system with the 6.5-inch screen in the Altima and 7-inch screen in the Versa. The system on the Versa and Sentra is a 5-inch screen. But you'll see it. It's a very good system. Very good system.
And the pricing is the same on the 6-inch, the 6.5-inch?
No. The $400 system is the 5-inch system.
Oh, no, I mean, I'm sorry, the pricing remains the same from year to year on the other system?
Yes. Greatly enhanced, but the same price.